Hola, 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 lovelies. Hello, and how is everyone? I hope everyone is doing well. So we are going to do a makeup Valentine's. It's coming around the corner. So we are gonna do a Valentine look using my iconic palette from Farmacy. And we're gonna be using three colors. You may think three colors, like, it's intimidating, but actually it really isn't. I'm gonna show you an easy way. So we're going to be using the color Mermaid, Passion, and Myth. Mermaid, Passion, and Myth. Those are the three colors that we're gonna be using. And this is from the palette from Farmacy. It's called Iconic. And you can get it on my store. And I will link my store in the description. So what we're gonna do first is tie up the hair. Get the hair out the way. Not too crazy. Okay. Good, good. Okay, so we're gonna start off with priming. We're going to prime. Where's my primer? We're gonna prime. I'm going to be using my BFX Pro. This one is kind of like it's kind of a moisturizing primer. But not really completely moisturizing. So you definitely want to prime before anything. Remember, if you don't prime, it's a crime. And you do your 5 points. Okay, and you just massage it into your skin. Gently. Remember, primer is silicone, so it's not going to go into your pores. It's just going to lay on your skin, and it's going to create a nice canvas for you to put on your makeup. And even if you don't wear makeup, you do want to use primer because it protects your skin from the elements outside. All that nasty stuff that's in the air that lands on your face, primer will keep it from going into your skin, into your pores. Okay? So that's that. Now what we're going to do is we're going to put some concealer on the top lid so we can concentrate on our eyeshadow. I'm going to be using Ivory. This is 04 Ivory. You can also get this at my store. So we're just going to put it on the top lid. Hold on, let me settle myself here. Okay, so we're just gonna apply it on the top lid only for now, because we're just gonna be working on the eyeshadow. So we're gonna put very gently with your ring finger, you are going to apply it all over the top lid until you cover your whole lid. Then I'm gonna go with my translucent powder. I wanna set it. And the reason why I wanna set it is because you get oils in your eye and it creates creases. So before I go to my other eye, I'm definitely going to put translucent powder on my whole lid just to keep it from creasing. There you go. Easy. Let's go to the other eye. Ring finger. And just dab it. There you go. Again, now we're gonna take the translucent powder and just put it on the whole eyelid and seal it. There you go. Now we're going to go in with the okay, so I'm going to take the blending brush and I'm going to go with the mermaid color, which is this one right here. And I'm just going to apply it on the top of my lid and the middle, from the middle to the top only. I'm definitely going to go in the corners, but I'm just going to concentrate on that. Hold on. I'm bringing it all the way up to my eyebrow. The reason why I'm doing that is because you have to figure out the kind of eyelid that you have. I have kind of a hooded eye, slightly. So I have to apply it where I have to apply the makeup a little bit higher. Then maybe if you didn't have a hooded eye, you can actually... There's different ways to apply the eyeshadow, depending on your eyelid. So again, I'm going just putting to the top. I'm reaching to the top of my eyebrow. And in the middle where the crease is, this is where I'm applying this. And I'm stopping right at the corner where my eyebrow ends. And that's it. And that's Mermaid. You really can't see it. It's very light. But it's there. I don't know if you can see it. It's there. It's shimmer. It's there. You can see it. We'll clean that up later. It's the fallout, actually. We'll clean that up later. Okay, now we're going to go with a packing brush. This is a packing brush. And it's like roundish. And this is just so you can pack on your eyeshadow and apply it. I'm going to be going with the color Myth, this darker one right here, very pretty. And I'm going to be applying it in the bottom of the lid, going up above the crease a little bit, but I'm not going to bring it all the way down because I'm going to put a highlighter in there. Okay, so we're going to stay away from the corner just to open up the eye a little bit. So basically with the brush, what you do is you just go from side to side. You want to grab the eyeshadow. Okay. You definitely want to hit it out because this actually, it has a little bit of fallout. So you want to be careful. Okay, so now I'm just applying it the corner of my eye. I'm going up above my crease, slightly higher above my crease because I have hooded eye. So I'm going above it slightly. And I'm leaving my inner eye. I'm not bringing it all the way down. Okay. Let's grab a little more, add a little more color. Okay. And when you use a packing brush, you're not brushing it on, you're dabbing it on. You dab it, you pack it on your eye. We have rough edges, but you know what? That's okay because we're going to go with a blending brush later and we're going to fix that. Okay. And the same on the other eye. eye, dabbing it, and put on the whole eye. Remember, above the crease, you're going up slightly higher. And you're going to stop right in the corner. And go down. Trust the process, ladies. Trust the process. Okay. Let's grab a little more. Like that. That's a pretty color. It's called Myth. And we're gonna dab some more, put some more on. Now you could apply, there's different techniques to do with eyeshadows. There's different ways to apply it. You just have to play with it. See which one works for you, which one works for your eye shape. But there's different ways to apply it. Now I'm going to take from my highlighter palette. This is also from my store. And I'm going to take this pinkish color right here, highlighter. And I'm going to use a small blending brush. And I'm just going to apply it on the inner eye. Going to the corner. And put some in the corner. And the other eye. You're bringing it to your inner corner because you want the highlighter to actually go to your inner corner. Pretty. You can drag that highlighter into the other eyeshadow just to blend it in. You drag it. That's blending it. Where you don't see that harsh line. Okay, now we're gonna go with the blending brush. This now. We're going to go with the blending brush, and now I'm going to go and I'm going to drag that dark color. I'm just going to drag it in. I didn't go back to the eyeshadow. I used the same eyeshadow that's on my eye, and I'm just dragging that color that's there, dragging it down. And then just blending out the corners in circular motions just to get rid of that harshness in the corner. And bring it down. See how that blends it out? You're doing the same on the other eye. Very simple. And in the corner, I'm just going in circular motions just to blend it out. Dragging it down. Okay, now we're going to go with the mermaid color, this color right here, with the same blending brush. We're going to grab some And we're gonna apply it above, right on the top, right over where that dark color ended. I'm gonna add it right on top, just to blend it out. And on the other eye. Look how pretty and soft. I'm gonna clean this up. I have some makeup remover here, and I'm gonna clean up the bottom of my eye. We're basically done with that makeup. Look how soft, look how pretty. Now, if you look at this color, Myth, it might look intimidating to you because it's so dark, but look how pretty. It doesn't really have to go on that dark. And if once you blend it in with the lighter colors and blends in, it looks really pretty. I'm gonna take my makeup remover and I'm just gonna go under my eye, just to get rid of the fallout. I'm gonna add some more primer because I'm kind of taking off my primer right now, but I'll add a little more. There you go. Okay, let's add a little more primer because we took some off once we did the makeup remover. So just a little bit. This color looks so pretty, so soft, perfect for Valentine's, I think. Okay, so now I'm gonna use, I'm gonna go in with my foundation. I'm going to be using, for foundation today, I'm gonna be using the serum foundation. This is an 05. Okay, what I usually do is I wet my brush with like two sprays of the rose water, just to get a little moist. And then I take my foundation, and I'm gonna put maybe about 4 drops of my foundation. So you go 1, 2, 3, 4. That was a big one. Okay, and then you dab. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You do your 5 points. I'm a firm believer in trying to keep your makeup as natural as possible. Those videos that you see, the girls where they're doing all that makeup and they do their eyebrows and they do, you know, these awesome looks. I mean, I watch those videos too, I'm not gonna lie. But to me, they're kind of like for entertainment purposes. I mean, you do learn some tricks, but for the most part, you're really not spending that much time. You really don't have that much time in a day, especially if you're on the go and you're working and you don't have you don't have enough time for that. I like to try to keep it as natural as possible. So that way, when you take off your makeup, you're not looking so much as a shock. Okay, look at how pretty. And this is like a velvety foundation. I love this foundation. This is 05. That's the color that I used. Okay, now I'm gonna go with the concealer, Pure Beige 04. You can get this at my store. And I'm gonna put it under my eye. Okay, and then I take my finger, my ring finger, and I just dab. Very lightly. You can use a blending bud if you choose to. Or your finger, it does the job as well. And you make sure that you blend it out by tapping it all the way around the edges, just to tap it out. There you go. I'm gonna go with my translucent powder, and I'm just going to seal the bottom part of the where the concealer is at. I'm just gonna add very little, just to seal it, just to set it. I'm not going to. I think I need to add just a little bit more in the corner. Let me just go back with my blending brush and just add a little bit more in the corner. Just to, well, when I put the concealer on, it kind of took a little bit off, so I'm just going back. But not too much, just to straighten it out. Go. Okay, now what we're going to do is we are going to contour. To contour. So for contouring, what I usually do is I use my Sunkissed bronzer. This is also in my store as well. This thing is huge. This will last you like forever, and you can leave it in your will for your kids. It's humongous. So here I take my contour brush that's at an angle, and I just dab. Okay, my forehead, just close up the forehead. I'm gonna take the other end of the brush, grab some more, and I'm going to put some going down, contouring just the top portion of my nose, and then I'm gonna go across. Now it depends on the look that you want, that you're going for with your nose. You have different ways of contouring your nose to give it a different shape. I do it because it's kind of long, so it kind of like divides it and it makes it a little shorter. I don't need to make it thinner because I don't really have to thin out my nose, but I do like to make it shorter. So you have different ways of contouring and just making it look different a little bit. Go. are going to, now what we're going to do is we are going to take, to do the eyeliner underneath. I'm not going to use a liquid liner because the liquid liner, actually what it does is kind of like, it makes it, it kind of gives it a harsh look. I like to give it a softer look. So I like using usually the color of the eyeshadow that I use just to make it softer. So I'm going to go back with that myth color. And I'm going to use a thin brush, like a liner brush, smudge brush, whatever you have. And then just go under the eye. Just apply it. And it just gives you a soft look. It's not harsh. And I'm just doing it at the corner of my eye. I'm not bringing it all the way down. I'm not bringing it all the way in. I mean, you can if you want to close up the look, if you want to have a more dramatic eye, or you can just leave it open. Since I want a soft look, I'm going to keep it at the edges. I'm not going to bring it all the way down. I'm going to clean my brushes. Okay, now what we're going to do is I'm going to put a little bit of concealer so I can highlight. So I'm putting a little bit of concealer where you highlight. Same color, the pure beige. You're going to put a little bit here, 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 and here. This is where you highlight. I'm going to go with a small blending bud, again with the rose water. You wet it. You want it damp, but you don't want it too wet. Okay, and then you're just going to dab. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use that pink highlighter that I used for in the corner of my eye. I'm going to highlight with that pink because this is a highlighter palette. So I'm going to use this pink to highlight. So you just highlight right above where you contoured. You're gonna put the highlighter right there, right above the contour. Okay. What I'm gonna do also is a little bit of blush. To be using like a blush brush, and I'm going to be using a light color. Let me see, I wasn't anticipating this one. I'm going to use this light peachy color one. So this you can also get in my store. This is sugar pink. So right in the apple of your cheek, you're just gonna add a little bit. Just a little bit. Okay. Just want to look a little bit, a little blushed on your cheek. Okay, don't forget the eyebrows. We have to do the eyebrows, keeping the eyebrows simple. Again, in my store, you can get the gel for the brows. I use clear because, in all honesty, I just like to brush them and just leave it. Like I said, I try to keep as natural as possible. There you go. That's it. The other eye, you brush up. You brush your eyebrows up. There you go. That's it. Now what we're going to do is we have a couple more steps. I think basically for the most part, mascara. So I don't know if I should use black or if I should go with pink. I don't know, honey, what should I do, black or pink?
Pink.
Okay, we went with pink. So I got a pink mascara. This is from ColourPop. This one is called Pink Ink. I got it from ColourPop. So what you have to do when you're putting on these mascaras, you actually have to use a primer. So I got a primer from L'Oreal. This is Voluminous. It's white. So you do one eye at a time. So you put on the primer. You can also mink it. You can do black and pink. You could do black and then just mink it, which means you put the pink at the tip. That also looks good if you don't want to do it all pink. You can do that as well. You can mink it. Okay, so now we're going to go. This is ColourPop BFF Mascara in pink. Remember, it's Valentine's. So go for it, ladies. Just go for it. These mascaras, I like it because of the color. They really don't curl and it really doesn't give you length or fill it in. But it just makes, it gives you a nice, pretty color. See that? Look how pretty. So we're going to do the other eye, putting the primer on the other eye. Remember, you want to wiggle it back and forth to get it in between your lashes. And then you twirl. I love it. Isn't it pretty? So pretty. Make sure you do not let the primer dry before you put on the mascara, because then it's going to be a little bit hard to put the mascara. So you definitely want to put it on. I mean, you can let it dry a little. You don't want to put on the mascara when the primer is too wet. But you don't want to let it dry either, because then it's going to be hard to put on the mascara. I'm the only one who needed saving. Isn't that pretty? just look at it for a moment. Okay, so let's add a little bit in the bottom. We're gonna go with the primer. I usually put it just in the corner. I don't go all the way. So I'll put some primer in the corner. And then I will put the mascara. Vaya, mira eso. Mira eso. Primer. And then mascara. Look at that. How pretty is that? So pretty. So pretty. I got a couple of them. I got pink. I got purple. I got red. I can't wait to use this red one. This is the bomb.com. I got teal. Yeah, I got teal. And I got blue from NYX. This is NYX. I got blue, so I can't wait to use these colors. Okay, now what's left is the lipstick. I don't know what I want to do with the lipstick, actually. I don't know if I want to go with a pink color or maybe like a reddish. It's Valentine's, so I don't know if I want to maybe go like with red. I'll do like a pink. I'll do a pink with a light pink, and I'll do an ombre look because I love doing ombre looks with my lipsticks. So basically what you do when you're gonna do the ombre look, you just outline. Then you fill it in the corner. Make sure you go all the way in. Okay. The corner on the top. And I'm going to take the pink. You can also find in my store. This one, actually this color that I used here. Jeez Louise. I don't know, I can't see it. Well, it's 103. And then this one is O2. This one is Pink Club. And I just add in the middle. When you're mixing it, you don't put your lips back and forth like that. You go. It's kind of like soap dabbing. You can dab them in the corner. Just kind of blend it out. Look at that, how pretty. I like that. I like that. And then if you want to add some shimmer to it, I kind of like it like this, but I also like a little bit of shimmer. So I am going to add a little sparkle. I have these also in my store. You can find this in the Sparkle Lip Glosses. I know there's like a pinkish one. Here you go, this one. This is pretty. And I'm just gonna dab it. That is a pretty, pretty Valentine look. Isn't that, look how pretty. Simple. Didn't use a lot of eyeshadow, just three colors with the highlighter. Foundation, a little bit of foundation. Highlight, contour, ombre the lipstick with a little bit of, with a lip gloss on top of it. You can find these at my store. The eyeliner, you use the same eyeshadow. And there you go, look how simple and how pretty. So we'll do more Valentine looks, so stay tuned. So this is one of them. I hope you enjoyed it. I will link my store. I'll put it in the descriptions, or I will link it on top. If it's Facebook, it's going to go on top. If it's YouTube, I'm going to put it in the descriptions. And if it's on Instagram, I will put it on the comments. You'll see it in the bottom. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Please like, share, and subscribe the videos. And any comments, please hashtag hola so I know that you were here, you saw the video. Like, share, and subscribe. And I thank you all. Thanks for watching. To the next one. Bye.